We have started to understand decision control statements. So if statement last time we have seen, now this is the ninth point PY program where we'll understand for if condition we can use logical operators. Now here I'm using logical operator as AND, which will help me here to combine two logical conditions. This is first logical condition, this is second logical condition. So three values we have initialized here: A is equal to 200, B is equal to 33, C is equal to 500. And with this if decision control statement, we are trying to combine two conditions with the help of logical AND. So A is greater than B and A is greater than C. If both logical conditions will remain true, then only body or block of the if statement will be executed. So let us check in this case. So 200 is greater than 33. So first logical condition remains true. Now value of C is equal to 500, which is greater than 200. So in this case, both logical conditions are remaining true, and we have combined with logical AND, because of which entire logical condition for if statement will become true, because of which this body will be executed. It means it will display both conditions are true. Let us check it. So I'm executing this program. We'll get this message. This message will be displayed on the output console. Both conditions are true. So in this way, logical AND operator can be used where we will be combining more than two logical conditions. So it is applicable, it is allowed for if statement. Only one thing we can understand, so round brackets are not required. Okay, without using round brackets we can write our logical conditions and it will be evaluated. Semicolon will represent start of the if block. Okay, start of the if block. In this way, if statement can be, for if statement we can use logical operators. Okay, so logical AND. So let us go to next program, that is 10.py, where we'll understand logical OR. So this is the example where now we'll be understanding logical OR. Same things. So initialization is done. A is equal to 200, B is equal to 33, C is equal to 500. If is keyword, then one blank space, and logical conditions, two logical conditions which we have combined with logical OR. OR is keyword that needs to be written in small case letters, that we have seen. So first logical condition, this is second logical condition. Now in this case, first logical condition remains true. Okay, similarly second logical condition remains false. But out of both conditions, if one logical condition remains true, and if we have combined both logical conditions by logical OR, in that case what will happen? Body will be executed, because this entire condition will remain true. From the truth table of OR, we can say entire logical condition is remaining true in this case, because of which it will display at least one logical condition is true. This message will be executed because one condition remains true. Okay, so this is the use of logical OR. When both logical conditions will remain false, then only this particular statement will not be executed. If I will change first logical condition, now in this case both logical conditions will remain false, because of which this statement will not be executed. Let us check it. Okay, it means out of both conditions, either one of the conditions from out of both conditions should remain true, then only entire condition we can say it will remain true and body will be executed. So this is the use of logical OR. Let us go to next program. So 11.py. Now here we'll understand nested if statement. So in C, C++ also we have understood how to use nested if else. Similarly in Python also we can use nested if statement. So in this case, what we'll be doing, in one if statement we can use another if statement, another if else we can write. So this structure is called as nested if. Okay, so let us understand with example. X is equal to 41, then if, okay, X is greater than 10, so 41 is greater than 10, this logical condition will remain true. Colon represents start of the first if statement. Okay, this is the block where block will be started. So print above 10, it means value of X is 41, so it is above 10. This message will be displayed. So first instruction number 10 will be executed as this logical condition remains true. After this, what will happen? Next if condition that we have mentioned in the block or body of the first if statement. So in this case, this if statement we will call it as outer if, and this is our inner if. Inner if is present inside the body of the outer if statement, therefore it is called as nested if statement. Now this is the inner if statement, where one more logical condition we have written, that is x is greater than 20. Now value of x is 41, 41 is greater than 20. Second logical condition will also remain true, because of which body of the second if statement will be executed. It means it will execute and also above 20. So value of x is 41, which is above 10. This message also will be executed. Again, it will execute this statement also, because x is greater than 20, 41 is greater than 20, because of which this message also will be displayed on the output console, and it will display and also above 20. But it will not execute this part, because it is else part for this if statement. So if I will execute this program on the output console, will get above 10 and also above 20. So in this way, nested if statement can be used, where one if statement that we are writing in another if statement. So this is our outer if statement, this is inner if statement. Different logical conditions can be tested. If they are remaining true, accordingly certain statements will be executed. Okay, so let us understand another set of input. So I will pass comment to this x is equal to 41. I will remove comment for x is equal to 15. Now for this, what will happen? First of all, logical condition for if statement, outer if statement will be tested. 15 is greater than 10. This logical condition will remain true, because of which it will display this message above 10. Really 15 is above 10, so this message will be displayed on the screen. But after this, it will go to inner if statement. Now value of x is 15. 15 is greater than 20. This logical condition will become false, because of which it will not execute this statement. It will go to else part and it will execute body of the else statement. So but not above 20 will be displayed. It means when value of x, when another set of input will consider x is equal to 15, in that case it will display above 10 and directly it will jump towards but not above 20. So let us check it. So in this way we'll be getting results. So this is the way with which we can use nested if statement in the Python. I hope you have understood. So this is 11.py. Let us go to last one, 12.py, where we'll understand pass statement. What is the meaning of pass statement? So sometimes, if suppose you are writing big programs, in that case what will happen, you want to use if statement and you don't want to execute particular you don't want to execute entire body for this if statement. In that case, we cannot keep this body as empty. If we'll be doing so what will happen? Python interpreter gives error. So let us check it. So simply what I'm doing, I'm using two Python variables. Value of a is 33, value of b is 200. Logical condition, if statement is used, logical condition is mentioned, b is greater than a colon, then nothing is mentioned. So I'm passing comment. So I will remove this. Now if I will execute, so it will give error. We cannot keep body for the if statement empty. Therefore, what will happen? It will be giving error, syntax error, unexpected UOF, end of file. We can read it as end of file while parsing. So it means we cannot keep this body as empty. And in such cases, if suppose you don't want to write anything in the body, but further program you wanted to write, okay. Further means what? Here I want to write, say welcome, print, I will write print function. And suppose welcome message I want to display. So only one statement, okay. But this particular body I don't want to execute. So further part I wanted to execute, that will not be executed because of this. We cannot keep body or block of the statement empty. So in such cases, what we can do, simply we can write pass, which is keyword. And when we'll be writing this statement pass, so what will happen? It means you don't want to execute block or a body of the if statement, so pass statement will really pass from control from body of if to outside the body, and next statements will be executed. So whatever error will be getting in earlier case, that error will not get if we'll be using pass statement. That's why when you don't want to write or execute entire if statement or a body of the if statement, in such cases we cannot keep it as empty. So instead of keeping it as empty, we can write one statement, name of that statement is pass. So this pass statement will help us to bring cursor from outside this body and nothing will be executed here. That's why pass statement simply passes the control, or it is to avoid getting an error. We can write this particular instruction or statement. That's why pass statement plays very vital role when you want to keep body empty. Now if I will be executing, it will be executed, it will not execute this particular. See, here B is really greater than 33, then pass statement will be executed, but nothing will be executed by the pass statement. Simply to avoid that error, we have mentioned this pass statement. Directly it will go to next statement and welcome message will be displayed. But if here I will write, say, print logical condition is true, so when this message I will use, so this message will be executed, logical condition is true, then pass statement will be executed and it will go to next statement, that is welcome. But normally if you don't want to write anything, then only we are using pass statement. That you can understand, you can remember. So in this way, if you want to keep, in short, if you want to keep your if statement empty, then in that case error will be encountered by the Python interpreter. In such cases we can write a pass statement as part of the block or body of the if statement to avoid the error. So simply in this way, what we can do, we can understand. Now here the decision control statements are over, we'll move towards the next, that is while looping control statement. So in case of while looping control statement, looping control statements are the statements where certain statements will be executed again and again. So if certain statements we wanted to execute again and again, in that case looping control statements are used. So in Python we have two looping control statements, while looping control statement and for looping control statement. One by one we'll understand. Let us start with while looping control statement. So this is the first program which I have opened. So we have only two looping control statement, that is while and for. So while looping control statement, already in C++ we used this looping control statement. Initialization is required, then logical condition and updation. Now one more thing, if we'll be writing our code in Python language, we cannot use increment operator, we cannot use decrement operator. It means I++, plus I, such statements we cannot write in Python. These statements are not allowed. Instead of which, we have seen shorthand assignment operator we can use, that is I plus is equal to 1. So such kind of operator we can use, where what will happen, meaning of this statement already we have seen, its meaning is I is equal to I plus 1. So such statements we can use. We cannot use it for updation, we cannot use increment or decrement operator. That thing let us remember. Now let us understand how to use while looping control statement in case of Python. So this is initialization, I is equal to 1. I is looping variable, we will call it as looping variable. So initial certain value needs to be stored initially, so we are storing value of I as 1. Then while i is less than 6, so I is less than 6 means what? This is the logical condition. So when this logical condition will become false, then only execution of the while loop or body or block of the while loop will be stopped. Otherwise it will be executed again and again. So initially value of I is 1, 1 is less than or 1 is less than 6, logical condition will remain true. It will go to body, so colon will represent start of the block. So these two statements are part of the body of the while looping control statement. These two statements will be executed again and again, and every time logical condition is tested or checked. So first of all, I is equal to 1, 1 is less than 6, logical condition will remain true, because of which it will print value of I as 1 on the output console. Then it will go to this statement, value of I will be increased by 1, it will become 2, 2 is less than or equal, 2 is less than 6, again logical condition will remain true. Next value of I, which is 2, it will be displayed on the screen. Then value of I will be increased by 1, it will become 3, 3 is less than 6, again true. Third value, 3 will be displayed on the screen. Then value of I will become 4, 4 is less than 6, again logical condition will remain true. Fourth value will be displayed on the screen, again value of I will be increased by 1, it will become 5, again logical condition will be checked or tested. 5 is less than 6, again logical condition will remain true. Fifth value of I will be displayed on the screen, which is 5. Then again value of I will be increased by 1, it will become 6, 6 is less than 6, logical condition will become false, and further this body will not be executed. It means for this program on the output console, value of I will be displayed on the output console. It will start from 1 to 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 values will be displayed on the screen. Let us check it. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 values will be displayed on the screen. In this way, what happens? While looping control gets executed. So I'm moving towards next program, that is second for while. Now let us understand break statement. Okay, break statement in C, C++ also we used break statement. So with the help of break statement, what will happen? We can bring our cursor outside the while loop. Okay, so let us understand. Simply, if you want to bring your cursor, this is the while loop. This is the body of the while loop. Okay, sorry, this is the body of the while loop. This is the body of the while loop. And if you will observe this, this is the body of the if statement or block of the if statement, and this is the entire body or block of the while loop. Now what will happen? If you want to bring your cursor or control outside this while loop, in that case break statement is used, and break statement we cannot write alone, so it should come along with particular decision control statement. So when you wanted to break your flow of execution for this while loop, so for breaking, particular logical condition is required, and that we are writing with the help of as a decision control statement. It means by using if statement we can break it. So let us understand this program, how it will be executed. Initially, if we'll be using while, it means initialization of looping variable needs to be done. That is done over here. I is equal to 1, then while is keyword that we have written, then logical condition we have mentioned over here, I is less than 6. Colon represents start of the body or block of the while loop. This is the first statement in the while loop. We are printing value of I. So I is equal to 1, 1 is less than 6, logical condition will remain true. First value of I, which will be displayed on the output console, that will be 1. Then it will check this logical condition. 1 is equal to 3. Logical condition is not remaining true, because of which break statement will not be executed. It will go to next statement. For while looping control statement, body or block of the while loop, that is I plus is equal to 1, it means value of I will be incremented by 1, it will become 2. Again logical condition will be tested, 2 is less than 6, logical condition remains true. Second value of I will be displayed on the screen, that is 2. Again 2 is equal to 3. Logical condition, again it will remain false, break statement will not be executed, it will go to I. Plus is equal to 1, value of I will be incremented by 1, it will become 3. Again, logical condition will be tested. 3 is less than 6. Logical condition remains true. Third value of I will be displayed on the screen, that is 3. Now, this if logical condition is tested, 3 is equal to 3. Logical condition remains true. Break statement will be executed in this case, because of which further it will not go to this statement. Control of the interpreter will be jumping outside the while loop, and in this way program will be ended. It means value of three values of I will be displayed on the screen, that is 1, 2 and 3. Let us check it. 1, 2 and 3. Okay. So in this way, if you wanted to bring your control outside from this while loop, so we have break statement, but break statement we cannot write alone. It should come along with particular decision control statement. So logical condition that we have written by using if statement, in this way we can break flow of execution for while loop. So we'll be getting on the output console only three values of I will be displayed on the output console, 1, 2, 3. In this way break statement is used. So this is the use of break statement. Let us go to next program, that is third one, continue statement. So similar to break statement, there is another statement that is continue. In C++ also we have seen this statement. Similarly in Python also we can use this continue statement. Continue statement continues your execution. Okay, in case of break statement it was stopping our further execution for that particular body or block of the while loop. But in case of continue statement, what happens when continue statement is executed, it will start executing for further. Simply it will skip this and it will start and next value of I that we'll see and how program will be executed. Now in this case initialization we have done for I is equal to 0. We are starting from 0 while logical condition is mentioned over here. 0 is less than 6. Logical condition remains true. I plus is equal to, okay. So we cannot use I plus plus, that already I told you. Okay. We can write I plus is equal to 1. So meaning of this statement is I is equal to I plus 1. So value of I we are increasing by 1. So initially value of I was 0. 0 is less than 6. Logical condition remains true. It will become 1. Value of I will become 1 over here. Then logical condition for this if statement will be tested, checked. 1 is equal to 3. Logical condition is not remaining true, because of which continue statement will not be executed. It will go to next statement. So these two statements I have passed comment that we'll see later on. So here I am writing print I. So first value of I, that is 1, it will be printed on the screen. After this again what will happen, it will go to here. Now value of I is 1. 1 is less than 6. Logical condition remains true. Because of this statement value of I will become 2. 2 is equal to 3. Logical condition is not remaining true. It will go to this statement, and second value of I, which is 2, it will be displayed on the screen. Further it will go to logical condition of while 2 is less than 6. Logical condition remains true. Because of this statement value of I will become 3. 3 is less than 3 is equal to 3. Logical condition remains true, because of which continue statement is executed, and control will be jumping from continue statement to here. Okay, it means when value of I is 3, at that time it will not be executing this statement number 10. From here directly it will jump to here. Now 3 is less than 6. Logical condition remains true. It will go to this statement. Because of this statement value of I will become 4. Logical condition is tested. 4 is equal to 3. Continue statement will not be executed. This logical condition is not remaining true when value of I is 4. Then directly it will go to this statement and it will print value of I as 4 on the output screen, output console. So from here again it will go to here. Value of I is 4. 4 is less than 6. Logical condition remains true. Because of this statement value of I will become 5. 5 is equal to 3. Logical condition again is not remaining true. Continue statement will not be executed. Directly it will go to statement number 10. Value of I, which is 5, it will be displayed on the screen. Again from here control of the interpreter will jump from statement number 10 to 4, and again logical condition is tested. Now value of I is 5. 5 is less than 6, logical condition remains true. Again, because of this statement, value of I will become 6. 6 is equal to 3, continue statement will not be executed, it will display, because of this print function, it will display value of I as 6 on the output console. Further, control of the interpreter will jump from statement number 10 to logical condition of while, value of I will become 7. 7 is less than 6, logical condition is not remaining true, so further execution of this while loop will be stopped. It means, because of this continue statement, values of I will be displayed on the screen, excluding when I is equal to 3. At that time, it means when value of I will become 3, at that time only continue statement will be executed. It means it will skip to execute this particular statement, print I, when value of I is 3, and because of which only 3 value of I will not be displayed on the screen. For remaining values of I, interpreter will display all values of I from 1 to 6 excluding 3. It will display 1, it will display 2, it will not display 3, it will display 4, 5 and 6. Let us check it. So it is displaying 1, it is displaying 2, it will skip 3 because of this if statement, it will skip 3, it will display 4, it will display 5, it will display 6. So this is the use of continue statement. Simply, we can continue execution of our while loop, and certain statements, if you don't want to execute, if you want to skip, in that case, continue statement helps to continue the execution without executing further statement of while loop. So that's why continue statement is useful. It means for specific logical condition we don't want to execute the iteration, we want to skip it, so in such cases continue statement is used. So in this way continue statement is useful. So I hope you have understood 3.py. Now last program for while looping control statement, we can use else statement. So this is the interesting thing. In case of C++, else statement we can use along with only if statement, but in case of Python we can use else statement along with while looping control statement. And here if you read this statement, we can run a block of code once when condition no longer is true. When this logical condition will become false, immediately what will happen if you want to execute certain block of statement? So by using else we can execute it. For example, when execution of while loop will be stopped, immediately what will happen? It will go to else part and it will execute this particular body. So let us understand this. Initially I is equal to 1, 1 is less than 6, logical condition will remain true. So it will go to here, first value of I which is 1, it will be displayed, then I plus is equal to 1, because of which value of I will be increased by 1, it will become 2, 2 is less than 6, logical condition will remain true. Again second value of I which is 2 will be displayed on the screen. Again because of this statement, value of I will become 3, 3 is less than 6, logical condition will remain true. Third value of I will be displayed on the screen, which is 3. Because of this statement, value of I will become 4. 4 is less than 6. Logical condition will remain true. Value of next value, which is 4, will be displayed on the screen. Because of this statement, value of I will become 5. 5 is less than 6. Logical condition will remain true. Fifth value of I will be displayed on the screen, which is 5. Because of this statement, value of I will become 6. 6 is less than 6. Logical condition will become false. It means, because of this while looping control statement, values of I which are varying from 1 to 6, out of which it will display 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 values will be displayed on the output console, and at the end when execution of this last logical condition, okay, logical condition for while will become false, directly it will jump towards else and it will execute body or block of the else statement, I is no longer, okay, less than 6. So this message will be displayed. Let us check it. 5 values, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then I is no longer less than 6 will be displayed on the screen. So in this way, else statement we can use along with while looping control statement. This is interesting. This is not possible in case of C++, but it is possible in case of Python. In short, else statement we can use along with while looping control statement. And when this logical condition will become false, immediately it will go to else part, and whatever will be writing in else, it will be executed. In this way, program gets executed. Okay, so this is the end of while looping control statement. We have seen while looping control statement. Now let us go to for loop. Let us understand how for loop is used in the Python. So first program I am opening, let us understand for loop. So if you will observe, for loop, basically for loop is used, okay, in case of different Python literals such as list, tuple, dictionary, set and string. So when such kind of Python literals will be using in the program, and if we want to access the data from all these types of Python literals, in that case we can go with this for looping control statement. Now let us understand with one example directly. So statement number 12, if you observe, so this is the list. Three elements, three values I have mentioned in this list. Name of the list is fruit. So first value is apple, second is banana, third is cherry. All values we have separated with comma, and as it is mentioned in the square bracket, so it will become, fruit will become list. So I am using list where three values we have initialized in the fruit list, and for loop is used in this way. Okay, for x is the any another variable, Python literal, Python variable, simple Python variable. So for is the keyword. So in, already we have seen, in is the membership function, membership operator. In is the membership operator. When any particular value is present in the object or not, okay, we can check it by using in, which is membership operator. So for loop is written in this way. For, then one blank space, x is any variable. Instead of x, I can write p, s, t, u, any variable you can mention. In where, in the fruits. So fruits is our list. So x in fruits, and every time what we'll do, we'll display value of x. So value of x will become apple. Okay, for first iteration value of x will become apple, for second iteration of for loop value of x will become banana, and for third iteration value of x will become cherry. In this way, print function will display all values of from the list one by one. Let us check it. Let us execute this program. So first value is apple, second is banana, third is cherry. In this way, what happens? And by using for loop, we can display, we can access all values which are present in the list. So only one thing we can remember, in is the membership operator. Now if I will pass comment to these two statements, and if I will remove comment from this statement, so already we have seen in, which is membership operator. So if I want to check apple is present in the list fruit or not, in that case we can mention value, then in is membership operator, which will relate, which will check apple is present in this list or not, in where fruits. So fruits is our object. So apple in fruits, if apple in fruits is true, it's if its result remains true, in that case it will display true on the output console. Okay, if suppose spelling is wrong, and if you are checking this value is present in the fruit object or not with the help of membership operator, in that case it will be giving false result. It means this is the membership operator. So this membership operator in we are using for along with this for loop, and how we are writing for is the keyword that needs to be written in small case letters. X is any variable. Okay, in name of our list, that is fruit. So print X. So each time different values will be displayed on the screen. Now instead of list, okay, if I will use say round bracket, it will become tuple, and rest of the thing will remain same. So it will display all values from the tuple one by one. So apple, banana, cherry. Okay, when I will use set instead of round bracket, I will use curly bracket, and if I will execute it again, it will program will be executed, it will display again values. But if you will find now here sequence is not remaining same, it means set is not an ordered collection, because of which sequence is not remaining same. But if you will use list and tuple, so sequence will be followed, it will be considered, and first value will be displayed as apple, second is banana and cherry. That also we can understand. So in this way for different Python literals we can use for loop, which will help us to display all values one by one by using for loop. Okay, let us go to next program, second. Now here if suppose you are using string, so this is the string, and if the for this string all characters I want to display one by one on the output console, in that case sequence of characters, string is nothing but sequence of characters, all these characters if I want to separate and separately I want to execute, in that case for loop can be used. So X is any variable, Python variable, in is membership operator, and this is the string. So for X in entire string, it means each time X will be considered as characters, separate characters. First of all it will display S, then it will display V, then it will display E, and so on. All characters will be displayed one by one on the output console. So for string also for loop is used. So let us check here, and if there is blank space, then blank space will also be considered as a character, and it will be displayed on the output console. So COE, after COE there is blank space, so here also you will get blank space. It means if your Python literal is string, and in such cases if you want to display all characters or sequence of characters one by one on the output console, in that case for loop is used. So after this for keyword, blank space is required, any variable, any Python variable. So here I will use another, say p, another variable p. So here I will mention p. So p is my Python variable. So for p in, then entire string can be written. And print p, it means it will display all characters one by one on the output console. Same output will get. One more thing, if suppose you will be using say name variable, and in this name variable entire string you want to store, which we have written over here, so I will write over here, then simply we can write name. This is also allowed. It means entire string can be stored in variable, and that variable can be mentioned over here. So for p in name, so in this case again we'll get same output. Okay, so either you can write direct string, or that string can be stored in any another variable, Python variable say name, and that name variable can be mentioned over here. In this way also we can use for loop. So for loop is used for string also. Okay, even strings are iterable objects. Why we are calling it as strings are iterable object? Because string is collection or group or sequence of characters. Okay, sequence of characters, and all characters if you want to display on the output console one by one, in that case for loop can be used. And so let us go to third program for for loop. This is the third program where we'll understand again break statement. So how we used break statement in case of while looping control statement, similarly break statement can be used in case of for loop. Now here fruit is again list, apple, banana and cherry, these are the three elements. So for loop is used for x is any another variable in fruits, fruits is our list. So print x means what? It will, we are asking Python interpreter to display all values of list one by one. But here condition is mentioned if x means what? Value of list. Okay, x is equal to banana. At that time, what we want to do? We want to break this execution of for loop. So when value of x will become banana, at that time break statement will be executed and further execution for loop will be stopped. It means if I will execute this particular program, in that case we'll be getting output as apple only. So I'll be executing this program, we'll get apple, then banana, see here, we'll see this. First of all, value of x will be apple. Okay, apple will be displayed, no doubt. Then it will check apple is equal to banana. Okay, at that time it will not be executing this break statement, it will go to next value of x, which is banana in fruits. Yes, logical condition will remain true. Then print x means what? Banana will be displayed on the screen. Therefore, banana will be displayed on the screen. Then logical condition is tested. At that time, value of x is now banana. Banana is equal to banana. Logical condition for this if statement will remain true. Break statement gets executed and further execution for this for loop will not be executed. In this way, what happens? For loop gets executed by using break statement. Hope you have understood. Once again, I will execute. Why we are getting two values of list? Apple and banana. Initially, see, this is the initialization of list. Three values we have initialized. Then for loop is used. X is any variable in Python in fruits. So value of x is nothing but for first iteration value of x will become apple. For second iteration value of x will become banana. For third iteration value of x will become cherry. In this way, for loop gets executed. So for first execution value of x is apple. Okay, apple in fruits remains true, that's why it will execute first statement from for loop. It will print, it will execute this statement, value of x will be displayed on the output console, that is apple, it will be displayed. Then if now value of x is apple, apple is equal to banana, logical condition for this if statement is not remaining true, break statement will not be executed. Directly it will jump to here again, value of x, which is next value of x will be considered, that is banana. Banana in fruits it is present. Okay, therefore logical condition if we'll be considering it, then it will remain true. Then it will go to here. It will print x is banana, therefore banana will be printed. Then it will go to if statement. Logical condition is now value of x is banana, banana is equal to banana, because of which this logical condition remains true and break statement gets executed. And as break statement gets executed, further execution of for loop gets stopped. It means cherry will not be executed over here. In this way, break statement is used in case of for loop also, similar to our while loop. I am moving towards next program, that is again in this case, okay, break statement is used only, but in this case what we'll be doing, first of all we are checking the conditions and then we are printing the value of x. Okay, sequence is little bit different. So this is the initialization of list. This is the initialization of list for x in fruit. So initially what will happen, value of x will be apple. If apple is equal to banana, logical condition is not remaining true, break statement will not execute, it will display apple. Okay, in this case first value will be displayed on the output console will be apple. After this, value of x will become banana. Banana in fruits is true. Okay, it will go to if statement, banana is equal to banana. Break statement gets executed and further execution for loop will be stopped. It means in this case now we'll get only one value which will be on the output console, that is output. Further execution will be stopped. Let us check it. Apple. Further execution for banana and cherry, it will not be executed because first of all logical condition is tested and then print function will be executed. In earlier program what we did, this print function was before this if statement, because of which first two values were displayed, okay, by the Python interpreter. But in this case, first of all, we are checking logical condition, and when banana value of x will become banana, at that time break statement will be executed and further execution for for loop will be stopped. In this way, what happens, for loop in the for loop we can use break statement. So okay, here we will stop. Now next we'll understand how to use continue statement in the for loop. So we used continue statement in case of while loop. Similarly, we can use continue statement in for loop. So let us understand with one example. It's similar. This is the fruit which is list. Three values we have initialized. For is the keyword. X is any variable in fruits, which is our list. Okay, X in fruit. So when for first iteration for this for loop, value of x will be apple. For second iteration, value of x will be banana. For third iteration, value of x will be cherry. In this way, for loop will be executed one by one. So first of all, when value of x will be apple, at that time it will check this logical condition for if statement. Apple is equal to banana. Logical condition will not remain true. It will not execute this continue statement. It will go to print function and it will execute apple first value on the output console. After this, what will happen? Value of x will be next value will be considered, that is banana. Banana in fruits, it is true. Therefore, it will go to this logical condition, and banana is equal to banana. Logical condition will remain true, because of which continue statement will be executed. For control of the interpreter, Python interpreter will jump from continue to here, and next value from the list, which is cherry, will be considered. Cherry in fruits, which is true, because of which again it will go to this logical condition of if statement. Cherry is equal to banana, which is not true. It will go to this printf function and it will execute cherry third value on the output console. It means on output console it will display apple and cherry. It will not execute banana. So I am executing this. You will get output on the output console as apple and cherry. It will not execute banana, because when value of x will become banana, at that time continue statement will be executed, because of which it will not go to statement number 9 directly. It will jump towards next value of list, which is cherry, and for cherry this will become false, because of which continue statement will not be executed, because of which print function will be executed and it will display cherry on the output console. In this way, what happens? Continue statement gets executed in case of for loop. It's similar like our while looping control statement. So I am moving towards next program, that is continue statement. Now if continue statement, this program we have seen, I will open program number 6. Now we'll understand range function, which already initially at the start itself we have seen range function. Now range function, by using range function also we can use for loop. Now let us understand with one example. So what happens? How range function will help us to display certain values on the output console. So for each keyword, x is any variable in Python, in is membership operator. Okay, range is the built-in method in Python. In the round bracket, 6 is mentioned. Now let us understand what is the meaning of 6. So when we'll be mentioning 6, it means we will be moving from up to 6, and it will start, if nothing is mentioned, it will start from 0. It will start with 0, it will end at 6. So initially value of x will be 0. 0 in range 6, it is present. Range 6 means what? 0 to 5. Okay, last value will be excluded. Last value will not be considered. It means from 0 to 5 it will be considered. And each time what will happen, when value of x will be initially 0, 0 in range 6, it is true. So range 6 is nothing but 0 to 5. Okay, range 6 is nothing but 0 to 5. So initially value of x will be 0. 0 in range 6, yes, it is true, because of which value of x, first value of x, it will display on the output console as 0. Then value of x will be increased by 1, it will become 1. 1 in range 6. 1 in range 6 means it is present. Therefore, second value of x, which is 1, it will be displayed on the screen. Again, value of x will be increased by 1. It will become 2. 2 in range 6. Yes, it is true. Therefore, next third value of x, which is 2, it will be displayed. Then 3. 3 in range 6. Yes, it is true. Therefore, again, it will display fourth value on the output console, that is 3. Again, value of x will become 4. 4 in range 6. Okay, 4 in range 6. It is also true. Therefore, fifth value of x, which is 4, will be displayed on the output console. Again, value of x will become 5. 5 in range 6. Yes, it is true. 5 value, which is actually 5 value. Actually, x value of x is sixth value, which is 5. Okay, it will be displayed on the screen. It means it will display 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Such 6 values will be displayed on the output console. Again, value of x will become 6. 6 in range 6, it is not true. Last value, which is 6. Range 6 means it will move from 0 to 5. So, 0 to 5 values we can consider. 6 value we cannot consider. It is beyond range, because of which these two statements, output of these two statements, it will display values of x. It will start from 0 to 5. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Such 6 values will be displayed. Let us check it. So in this way, we will be getting 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Such 6 values will be displayed on the screen. Okay. When I will write 5, so it will display 0 to 4, 5 values on the output console. Let us check it. 0 to 4, it means 5 values, 0 to 4. So this is the meaning. It means in this case, okay, in this case, in this range case of range 5, what happens? Value of x will be incremented each time by 1. By default, it will increase value of a variable of Python each time by 1. So this is the first example. I will be passing comment to this. Now I will remove comment from these two statements. Now here we'll see what happens. Now here we are considering two ranges. Okay, in the range function we are considering two parameters. I will call it as two parameters. In first case, we consider only one parameter, and if only one parameter will be considering, only one argument will be passing in the range function. So what will happen? Less than one of the range, which is mentioned in the round bracket as argument, we should consider till, okay, till that value we can increase value of x, and x value will start from 0 to argument which will be passing minus 1. So these many iterations will have for this for loop. Similarly, now here in this range function, I will be passing two arguments. First argument is 2, then second argument is 6, and comma represents separation of two arguments. It means two arguments we have passed in the range function. So let us understand meaning of this range function when we will be passing two arguments. So first it will start, okay, value of x, if nothing is mentioned, it will start with 0. But if first argument is mentioned, it means it will start with 2 and it will end last argument minus 1. It will end at last argument minus 1. It means it will end at 5. So how many values it will consider this range? Because of this range function, we can consider 2, 3, 4 and 5. Only 4 values we can consider. So output of this for loop will be, it will start and displaying value of x from 2 to 5, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, these 4 values will be displayed on the output console. Let us check it. It will start with 2, then 3, 4 and 5. It means 4 values will be displayed. Okay, 4 values will be displayed, but each time each value will be incremented by 1. Okay, so here also each time value will be incremented by 1. By default, increment by default 1. Okay, here also increment by default 1. Two arguments we are passing over here. First argument, it means here first argument, it will start with this value and it will end with a second argument minus 1. Till that value, what happens? For loop gets executed again and again. So 6 minus 1, 5, it will start executing from 2 to 5. So 4 values will be displayed for x, that is 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, so this is 6th point py. Let us move towards 7th point py, where what we'll be doing, we'll be using 3 arguments now in this range function. Let us understand what happens. In earlier cases, in first case we considered only one parameter, in second case we considered two parameters. Now this is the third example for for loop, where range function will have three arguments or three parameters. So first argument will be starting value, okay. Second argument will be the end, okay, end minus 1, okay. So you should suppose to go till 29, last value will be 29. 30th value we should not suppose to consider, value 30 we should not suppose to consider in the iterations. And each time, instead of increasing value 1, so third argument will represent from how many what kind of increment you want to do. So increment will be done with 3. Increment will be with 3, meaning of this 3, third argument will be increment will be with 3. It means we are increasing each time from 2 to 3, 30 if I want to move. So I need to consider differences of the values with this 3. It means if first value is 2, then 3, 4 and 5. So second value will be 5. Okay. In this way, what happens? Value of x, which is 2, which will be started with 2, it will be incremented by 3 each time. So next value of x will be 5 and so on. So it means if in the range method, which is built-in method, if we'll be using three arguments, three parameters, first argument represents start of the for loop. It means for loop will be started with this value. Then second argument, it means that is the boundary end point, but 30 value we cannot consider. We need to deduct this value. It means we are deducting 1 from this value. It means 29 will be the last value for this x, okay. And 3 means what? Increment will be done each time in the x of the x by 3. It means if first value is 2, so second value will be 5 and so on. Third value will be 8, okay. In this way, values of x will be displayed on the screen and it will go till 29. So I'm executing this program, we'll see it, we'll check it. So first value is 2, then 5, then 8, and 8 plus 3, 11, 11 plus 3, 14, 14 plus 3, 17, 17 plus 3, 20, 20 plus 3, 23, 23 plus 3, 26, 26 plus 3, 29. So till 29 it will go, and in this way we'll get values of x which will have a difference of this 3, third argument, that is 3. If I will write, say, 2, it in this case what will happen? First value will be 2, then second value will be 4, third value will be 6 and so on. So we'll get table of 2 in short. I'll be executing this. So we'll get table of 2, 2, 4, 6, okay, 8, 10. 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26, 28, till 29, okay, till 29. It will not go to 30. In this way, what happens? Range method is useful to display certain values, okay. So one example, if nothing is mentioned, it means it will consider all values, where value of x will be incremented by 1, okay. Value of x will be incremented by 1. It will start with 2. Okay, it will start with 2. It will end at 29. And in this way, you will get. It means third parameter, if we will not be using in that case, what will happen? By default, it will consider you need to increase value of x each time by 1. But when I will write 2, it means I want a difference between the values, I will start from 2 and I will end at 29, but difference will be 2. Each time value of x will be incremented by 2. Now if I will execute, I will get all even numbers from 0 to, it will start from 2 to 29. So this is the meaning. This is the range method. In this way, range method can be used. Now one more thing I wanted to show over here, which is, suppose I want to count, okay, if I will write 3, it means I want to start values of x from 2 and I want to end at 29, and each between each values of x, I need a difference of 3, okay, I need difference of 3, and such numbers if I wanted to display on the screen, so machine will display all such numbers on the output console, and if I want to count how many such numbers are present on the output console, manually you can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, okay, 10 such numbers are present. So if I want to give that task to Python interpreter, in that case what we can do, we can use one variable. Name of that variable is count. I will initialize value of count as 0. I will start with 0. When I will get first value of x, which is, say in this case 2, so immediately value of count should be increased by 1. So here we cannot write count plus plus. So I can write count plus is equal to 1, which will, this statement will help us to increase each time when value of x will be displayed. Immediately value of x count needs to be increased by 1, and simply it will count each time, it will count how many such values are present in the for loop. So outside the for loop, I will display total such numbers. So total count, manually we have counted it as a 10. Now if I will execute it, we'll get a 10. Value of count as 10. Okay, value of count as such numbers are 10. So in this way, okay, sometimes if you want to count how many such numbers which are having difference of 3, and we are starting from 2 to 29, so such numbers are present, so that number we can display on the output console by using any variable. Here I used count and I initialized it as 0 and we are counting it. This such kind of programs we have written in C++. Similarly, here also I wanted to give this example. Okay, so in this way, the seventh program we have seen. Let us go to next, that is eighth point, py, where we'll understand else statement. Now in case of while loop also we have seen else statement can be used. Similarly, in case of for loop also we can use else statement. Now how it can be used, that we'll see. When this execution of for loop gets stopped, immediately it will go to else and it will execute this statement. It means, for example, this already we have seen, for x in a range 6. Range 6 means what? We need to start with 0 and we need to end at 5. Each time value of x will be increased by 1. Nothing is mentioned, only one argument is mentioned. So that is the meaning. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, such 6 values will be displayed on this screen, and immediately. Execution of for loop gets stopped and it will go to else and it will display this message, finally finished. Let us check it. 0 to 5, all values will be displayed one by one to the new line, and then it will display finally finished. Let us check it. So it will start with 0, it will end at 5, and finally finished. So in short, else statement we can use in for loop along with this for loop. When it will be executed, when execution of for loop gets stopped, immediately it will be executed. It will be executed. This is not possible in case of C++. Else statement comes along with only if statement, but in Python, else statement comes along with while as well as for loop. Okay, so this we have seen. Program number 8, where we have understood we can use else statement along with for. When else statement will be executed, when execution of for loop gets stopped, immediately it will go to else and else part will be executed. So this is the 8th point, py. I will be moving towards next program, that is 9th. Now nested for loop, how to use nested for loop, that we'll see. First of all, I will pass comment to this part and I will remove comment from this. I will explain what is this nested for loop means what. In one for loop, another for loop is used. In case of C, C++, we have used nested for loop. Similarly, in Python also we can use nested for loop. So let us understand this. Okay, this is the first list. Let us call it as adjective. Okay, healthy, yellow, and tasty. These are the three values. ADJ is the first list. Okay, and in second list, again three more values I have initialized. First value is apple, orange, and cherry. And basically, this is the list. And name of this list is fruit. So let us consider. Okay, let us consider. We are using two for loops. So this is the outer for loop. For this is the inner for loop, which we have written inside the outer for loop. Okay, this is inner for loop, this is outer for loop. X and Y, these are the two different Python variables. Okay, you can use I and J, P and Q, any variables you can use. So I used X and Y. So for X, X is the looping variable. Okay, let us call this X is the looping variable for outer for loop, and Y is the looping variable for inner for loop. So X, for X in ADJ, this is the first list. For X, X is the Python variable which we'll be using for outer for loop. In is the membership operator. ADJ is the first list. Similarly, in this for loop, colon represents start of the body of outer for loop. So this is the body of outer for loop. And in this body of outer for loop, one more for loop is used, because of which we are calling it as nested for loop. And this is inner for loop, and for inner for loop we'll be using Y variable. And for Y in fruits, so fruits is the second list. So in this way, colon again represents start of the inner for loop, and in the inner for loop we are using print function. X and Y, values of X and Y, we are trying to display it on the output console. Now, how it will be executed, how nested for loop will be executed, that we'll see. Initially, it will start with execution of outer for loop. X value will be considered as healthy. Okay, value of X will be considered as a healthy. Healthy in ADJ, it is true, because of which it will go to inner for loop. Value of Y, which will be considered as apple. Initial value of Y will be apple. Apple in fruits, which will become true. Now, in this case, if we will try to display the value of X and Y, so value of X is healthy, and value of Y, first value of Y for inner for loop is apple. So healthy and apple will be displayed on the screen. After this, immediately it will go to inner for loop. Okay, it will not go to outer for loop, it will go to inner for loop. Next value of second list, which is orange, will be considered. Okay, value of X will remain same, which is healthy. So value of Y will become orange. Orange in fruits, which will become true. Value of X is healthy. Now value of Y is orange, second value. So it will display on the second rows to the new line. It will display healthy orange. Okay. Again from here, it will go to again here. Okay. Next value of Y, which will be cherry, it will be considered. So value of Y will become cherry. Still value of X is healthy. Okay. Still value of X is healthy, because of which, now value of X is healthy, value of Y is cherry. So cherry in fruits, which is true, it will go to this statement print. We are printing X and Y. Value of X is healthy, value of Y is cherry. So in third row, it will display healthy cherry. Okay. After this, again it will try to execute this Y, but further after this cherry, further values are not present, because of which execution of inner for loop gets stopped, and it will go to outer for loop. Value of X will be increased by 1, and next value of Y from the first list will be considered. It is yellow. So value of X will be considered as yellow. What happens, how it will be executed. Value of X is now yellow. Yellow in ADJ is true, because of which it will go to inner for loop. Again, inner for loop gets started. It will start with apple. First value of Y will be apple. Okay, apple in fruits, which will remain true. Value of X is now yellow. Value of Y, first value of Y is apple, so it will display yellow apple. Again, it will go here, value of Y, next value of Y, which will be considered as orange. Orange in fruits will remain true. Value of X is yellow. value of y is orange, so it will display yellow or orange. Then value of again y will be increased by 1. It will go to next value, that is cherry. Cherry in fruits, which will remain true. Value of x is still yellow. So yellow cherry. In this way, what will happen? It will display the message. Again, value of y will be increased by 1. It will become, it will try to find next value which is not present. So execution of inner for loop gets stopped. Again, it will go to outer for loop value of x, which will be considered next value, which is testy. Okay, testy. So testy in IDJ, which is true. Again, it will go to inner for loop value of y. Again, it will start from apple, orange and cherry. It will start with apple. Apple in fruits will remain true. Value of x is now testy. Value of y is apple. So it will display, okay, to the new line. It will display testy apple. Again, value of y will be increased by 1. Next value will be pointed. It is orange. Orange in fruits will remain true. Value of x is testy. Tasty orange, okay, that message will be displayed to the new line. Again, value of y will be increased by 1. Next value of y will be considered as cherry. Cherry inputs true. X is tasty. Tasty cherry will be displayed on the output console. So output of this nested for loop will be healthy apple, healthy orange, healthy cherry, then yellow apple, okay, yellow orange, yellow cherry, tasty apple, tasty orange and tasty cherry. In this way, output will be displayed. So total, how many number of rows will be displayed? 9. For healthy, 3 times. Okay. For healthy, 3 times. For yellow, 3 times. 6 rows. 6 rows. Okay. Tasty, 3 times. Total number of rows will be displayed on the output screen will be 9. It is similar to our... See here, healthy apple, healthy orange, healthy cherry, yellow apple, yellow orange, yellow cherry, tasty apple, tasty orange, tasty cherry. In this way, 9 statements will be displayed. 9 times printf function will be executed. So in this way, what happens? Inner for loop, nested for loop gets executed. So I am passing comment to this. Let us understand again nested for loop by using another example. So this is the another example where I will remove comment for this, and let us understand this example. So again, I'm using two lists, outer list and inner list. Okay, outer list values are 10, values are 1, 2 and 3. You can use another values. I will use 10, 20 and 30, and for inner list, values are 1, 2 and 3. So this is the initialization of two lists. Outer is the first list and inner is the second list. 10, 20, 30, these are the values for outer list. 1, 2 and 3, these are the values for inner list. So x and y, again two variables will be using. X will be the variable, looping variable for outer for loop, okay, outer for loop. Y is the another looping variable for Python which will be using for inner for loop. Okay, so outer is our first list and inner is our second list. So similar to this first example, we'll understand what will be the output for this. Initially, what will happen? Value of x will remain 10. When value of x will remain 10, for 10 values of y will be considered 1, 2, 3. So 10, 1, 10, 2, 10, 3. In this way, when initially inner for loop gets executed for 3 times, it will be executed for 1, it will be executed for 2, it will be executed for 3. But at that time, value of x will remain same, which will be 10. For first iteration of outer for loop, value of x will be 10, and for inner for loop will be executed thrice. For first iteration, value of y for inner value of y will be 1, then value of y will become 2 and value of y will become 3. In this way, what happens? Inner for loop gets executed. For these three values, value of x will remain same, which is 10. Therefore, first three rows will be 10-1, 10-2, 10-3. After this, what will happen? Inner for loop execution gets stopped. It will, control of the interpreter goes to here, and value of x, next value of x, which is 20, will be considered 20 in outer. Yes, it is true. again it will go to inner for loop. Now value of y, again it will be started from 1 to 3. So this, for these three values, okay, for these three values of y, value of x will remain 20, and because of this, three iterations for inner for loop will get different values of y, but will get same value of x, which is 20. So we'll get 21, 22, 23. So next three rows for inner for loop, for inner for loop's execution, will get 21, 22, 23. Again, value of, again, inner for loop execution gets stopped. It will go to outer for loop. Value of x will be considered as 30. 30 in outer, yes, it is true. Again, value of y will be considered as 1, 2, 3. For this, for last value of x, which is 30, for this 30, inner for loop gets executed for 3 times, but value of y varies from 1 to 3, because of which next 3 rows will be, okay, 31, 32 and 33. In this way, we'll get total number of rows will be displayed on the output console will be 9. Let us execute this program. So 10 1, 10 2, 10 3, then 21, 22, 23, 31, 32, 33. In this way, what happens? Total number of lines will get 9. Now if I will execute, to understand this, if I will execute one more element, so now in this case, what will happen? For this 10, okay, inner for loop gets executed 3 times. For this 20, inner for loop gets executed for 3 times. Again, for this 30, inner for loop gets executed 3 times. For this 40 also, inner for loop gets executed for 3 times. It means 3 1 3 2 7 3 3 9 3 4 12. Total number of total printf function will be executed 12 times, and it will be executed in this way. Let us check it. Okay. In this way, it will be executed 10 1, 10 2, 10 3, okay, 21, 22, 23, then 31, 32, 33, 41, 42, 43. In this way, what happens? We'll get output on the output console. If I will remove, okay, I will remove this 30, and if I will increase one more element in the inner for loop, in that case, what happens? Each time inner for loop gets executed 4 times. Okay, 4 times. It means for 10, it will be executed 4 times. For this 20, it will be executed 4 times. For 30, it will be executed 4 times. Again, in this case, what will happen? It will be giving, okay, number of rows. 4, 4, 4, 8, 12. Again, we will get n. But only in this case, for this 10, we will be getting 10. Okay, as inner for loop gets executed 4 times, so we'll get first 4 rows will be 10 1, 10 2, 10 3, 10 4. Next 4 rows will be 21, 22, 23, 24, okay, and next 4 rows will be 31, 32, 33, 34. In this way, what happens? For loop, inner nested for loop gets executed. So I will be opening next last program, that is 10th, okay, which we have seen in case of if statement. This we have seen, okay, pass statement. Similarly, pass statement can be used in for loop. If suppose you don't want to execute any statement in the for loop, so after colon we have understood. Now after colon, what happens? Body or block of the statement gets started, and if you don't want to execute, if you don't want to write any statement or instruction in the while, for, or if statement, in that case, what we can do, we can pass simply one, we can write one statement. Name of that statement is pass statement, and if this pass statement will write, it will not give any kind of error. Otherwise, if we'll be keeping, if we'll be keeping body or block of for loop empty, and if we'll try to execute, it will give error. Okay, and that error will be unexpected UOF while parsing. Okay, this such kind of error will get. So to avoid that error, we'll be writing, okay, pass statement. And if I will write pass statement, instead of keeping that body or body, okay, empty, what we'll be doing, we'll be writing pass statement. And when I will be writing pass statement, so we'll not get that error. So we can avoid, okay, errors if we'll be getting, if we are not mentioning any kind of statement in the body. In that case, interpreter throws an error. To avoid that error, simply we can pass this statement. In this way, in this way, what we can do, we understood, okay, for loop and its importance. Okay, so here let us take a pause. Now today's last part will be our what is mean by Boolean in Python. Okay, Booleans in Python. So five programs we have. This will end our session. So we'll understand what is mean by Boolean. Okay, Boolean means either true or false. That we'll see one by one. So Boolean represents one of two values. So out of these two values, true or false, that we have seen, okay, but we will be calling them as, okay, Booleans in Python, that we'll understand. If result will be getting either true or result if will be getting as false for logical conditions, in that case, it means these are nothing but Booleans in Python. So let us understand this with one example. This is one logical condition, this is another logical condition, and all these logical conditions will be passing in the print function as argument. So let us consider statement number 3, where print in the round bracket I have mentioned 10 is greater than 9. So this logical condition remains true. So its result will get true on the output console. When we'll execute it, we'll get true. Then next is 10 is equal to 9, will get its result as false. Then 10 is less than 9, again will get result as false. So such values if we'll be getting on the output console, so true or false is nothing but Booleans in Python. So I'm executing this, let us understand. Okay, so true, false, false. So true is Boolean in Python, false is Boolean in Python, false again is Boolean in Python. So Booleans represent one of two values, either it can be true or it can be false. In this way we can understand, okay, this is nothing but Boolean in Python. Now I am moving towards next program, that is second, where we'll understand again in detail what is meant by Boolean and how it helps. So this program also, such programs already we have seen in case of if statement, only we'll understand in terms of Boolean. Okay, so value of A is 200, value of B is 33. So if we'll check, this is the logical condition, it means always, okay, logical condition will give result in the form of Booleans. Now in this case, 33 is greater than 200, its result will be getting as false, and as this result will be getting as false, it will go to else and it will display B is not, okay, greater than A. I will be executing this. Okay, B is not greater than A. So in this case, result of this logical condition will be false Boolean, because of which it will go to else part. So false Boolean, it represents false Boolean value in the Python. This is the second program. Now we'll be moving towards third. We'll understand in third. See here, bool, B-O-O, bool. Bool is the function. Okay. Now this function, bool function, is built-in method in Python, and this function always evaluates one value, and that value will be either true or false. As Booleans are having only two values, either true or false, so bool function, if you will be using in the Python script, in that case what happens, it returns either true value or false value. Now let us understand how it can be returning values. This is the first instruction where print function we have used to display the result. So bool in the round bracket hello, this is the string, and if any string you will be passing as an argument in the bool function, and entire bool function with a certain argument if you will pass in the print function, so in this case what will happen, it will display result on the output console. And if you consider this as argument in print, so this will give either true or false. Now in this case, string is mentioned and this string is having certain value of this string is hello, and as this string is having certain value, because of which will be getting, okay, true. Its result will be displayed on the output console will be true because string has certain value. Another case, another example, statement number 6, if you'll observe, again bool and in the round bracket argument will be passing as number, say 15, which is non-zero. It means for this particular argument, value of this particular argument will be true because non-zero value that is mentioned in the bool as argument, and this will return true again. And if we'll be passing entire bool in the round bracket 15 as argument for print function, so it will return either true or false. And in this case, it will return true value on the output console. So for both statements, we'll get on the output console true, true. Let us check it. True, true. Okay. So in this way, bool method, bool function, which is built-in method that can be used sometimes if you want to check, if you want to return true or false values, simply bool function returns true or false value. It returns. Okay. According to the argument, very important, according to the argument. In the next program we'll see, but if I will remove, okay, now this is the string where we are not considered empty string. This is empty string. So result of statement number 5 will be false. Let us check it. So we'll get false. Again here, if I will pass 0 as a value in the boolean, so we'll get false again. So here also, instead of true, we'll get false. Let us check it. False, false. Okay, that we'll see. When for what kind of arguments we'll be getting false result, but normally, okay, hello. Normally, if we'll be passing certain values, we'll be getting result as true. I'll execute again, we'll get true, true. Now instead of passing direct values in the bool method, okay, if we'll be storing that value in another variable, say x and y, and if x and y will be arguments or parameters, if we'll be passing in the bool method, in that case also we'll be getting the same results. Now I'll pass comment to these two lines, two statements. I will remove comment from these two statements. I will remove comment for these two statements also. Now value of x is hello, which is string, value of y is 15, which is integer, and x and y will become, okay, arguments for bool method, bool x and bool y. So bool x means what? Hello string, okay, it will be represented in same way, but instead of writing string in the string as argument, here we are passing x, which is string type of Python literal. So its result also will get true. And for bool y, which is y is 15, which is integer value, which is non-zero, so here also we'll get true. So if I will execute again, we'll get true, true. Okay, so in this way, either directly value we can pass in the bool method, or that value we can store in the Python literal, and that Python literal or Python variable we can pass as argument for bool method. In both way we can use bool method. Bool is, okay, once again I'm repeating, bool is built-in method like our print method in Python. Okay, so we'll move towards a second last program for this bool method. Now for what kind of values, okay, for what kind of values we'll get result as true or false. For example, instruction number 7, if you will observe, this is the string which we have seen in already hello. It is similar to hello, okay, ABC. Then bool 123, integer value will be passing, so result of both statements will get true. Now in third case, where bool method again we are using, but in this case now instead of passing value, we are passing entire list. And if entire list will be passing as a argument for bool method, and if it is not empty, again will get true. Now if you will execute this, so you will not get anything on the output console because print method we haven't used. So if I will use print method, here also if I will use print method, okay, here also I will use print method. Now if I will execute, so for three statements we'll get and result as true, true, true. Let us check it. True, true, true. So it means from this program we can understand not only certain value we can pass as argument. If suppose you have list, you have tuple, you have set, you have dictionary, So all these Python literals also we can pass directly in the bool method, and if these Python literals are not empty, in that case we'll be getting result as true. That we can understand from this program 4.py. So let us understand last program for this boolean, okay, Python boolean. So here some examples I'll be putting in front of you, where what will happen if we'll be passing such arguments in the bool method, we'll be getting result as false always. Okay, false is keyword, none is also keyword, true is also keyword, okay. But this is the example where we'll be getting, okay, false result that we'll see. So in statement number 6, if false keyword you'll be passing in the bool method, which is built-in method, so we'll get false result. None means what? Again we'll get, if none we are passing as argument in the bool method, again we'll be getting result as false. If zero value, okay, non-zero gives true, but zero value if we'll be passing as argument in the bool method, again we'll get result as false. If empty string will be passing as argument in the bool method, again we'll be getting result as false. If empty tuple, round bracket means what? Tuple. If empty tuple will be passing as argument for bool method, again we'll be getting result false. Again, if empty list, if empty list as argument will be passing for bool method, again we'll be getting result as false. Curly bracket means what? Set. If empty set will be passing as argument for bool method, again we'll be getting result as false. So this will be checking by using print method. If without print method, if you will execute it, you will not get anything on the output console. Only if certain message you want to display, or you want to display some output on the output console, so print method we should use. So print, okay, so again I will write print round bracket complete, print round bracket complete, print, okay, round bracket complete, print, round bracket complete, print, okay, round bracket complete, print, round bracket complete, sorry, yes, round bracket at the end I need to complete. Now result of this statement number 6 will get false, result of statement number 7 also will get false, result of statement number 8 will get false, result of statement number 9 will get false, 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 false. Let us check it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 times will get false. Let us count. I will increase the size of output console. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, 7 times. 7 times we will be getting result as false. So, in short, for bool method, if we will be passing false, none, such kind of keywords, we will be getting result on the output console as false. Again, if we will be passing zero value, directly zero value in the bool method, again then also we'll be getting result as false. If we'll be passing empty string as argument for the bool method, again we'll be getting result as false. If we'll be passing empty tuple, okay, if I'll pass 1, 2, so we'll get true, okay, but if I'm not passing any value in the tuple, so I'll get result as false. It means empty tuple, empty list, empty set, if we'll be passing as argument for bool method, we'll be getting result as false. So in this way, booleans in Python can be used. In short, booleans are nothing but two values, either true or false. Out of these two values, one value will be considered as boolean in Python, and this is nothing but boolean. I hope you have understood. So just I will be closing this screen. Now what I will do, we have in the last half hour where we'll see the syllabus. Give me 1 minute. or what I will do, I will stop sharing this, recording this screen. Let us understand about syllabus. So I have opened on the screen, you will find this is the syllabus. So if you will observe carefully section 1, so almost section 1 I tried to cover. Unit number 1 that we have seen, okay, introduction to Python and computer programming, what is Python, types of Python, basic programming Python that we have seen, unit number 1 successfully we have covered. Then unit number 2, if you will observe data types, we have seen, okay, different types of data types in Python, variables, Python variables we have seen, basic input output operations we have seen, basic operators also we have seen in Python. So simple Python programs we have seen, Python literals where we understood, okay, in detail, list, tuple, set and dictionary, then different types of Python operators we have seen, variables in detail we have seen, okay, how to talk with computer, that also we are trying to understand with the help of different types of Python commands, how we can talk, how we can interact with machine or computer, that we have seen, okay. So unit number 3 where today we have seen, okay, Boolean values means what, true and false, that we have seen, conditional execution, if statement we have seen, okay, looping control statement where for loop and while loop, these two loops we have seen, list and list processing, that part already we have covered here in Python literals, okay. So list processing that we have seen, logical operators we have seen here, bitwise operators, bitwise operations that already we have seen in C++. So meaning will remain same in case of bitwise operators for C++ and Python. Then making decisions in Python by using if, if else, okay, elif statements, we can take proper decision. So decisions in Python can be taken with the help of if, if else, okay, elif. Elif will work similar to else if ladder. Then in Python loops, two types of loops we have seen, for loop, while loop, okay, do while loop is not present in Python, so that we are not using. Increment and decrement operator, if you want to do, we cannot do, like in C++, I++, I-, such kind of pre-increment, post-increment operators we cannot use in Python. Simply if you want to use it, you can use shorthand assignment operators. So I+= 1. So I+= 1 is nothing but I++, that we can use in Python. So logic and bitwise operations in Python we have seen, okay, list, collection, data, list in, lists in detail we have seen here in Python literals. So actually most of the part I tried to cover in unit number 2, okay, under this particular point, which was very big, and almost 3 to 4 sessions we have I conducted, okay, 3 to 4 sessions to understand what is mean by Python literals. So from that you can understand lists. Only one point which I have skipped, that we'll see in coming sessions, okay, sorting, simple list, how to sort, bubble sort, that we have seen in C language. So small program we'll see where we can do in a sorting and sorting for the list, that we'll see definitely, okay. More details list, about more details that we have seen lists in advanced applications, if I'll get one example, so that also I will try to cover over here. But most of the part, if you find that already we have covered, it means section number 1 almost I have covered. If only one point you will consider, that I will try to cover in coming sessions, but section 1 almost, which is very basic, and on the basis of section number 1, now we can complete, we can cover very easily section number 2, where we'll understand function, tuple, okay, functions, especially functions, tuples, dictionaries and data processing, that already we have seen in, again, chapter number 2. If you will observe this Python literal, so I covered tuple, dictionary, different functions which we can use in tuple, dictionary and data, how to do in a processing of data, that also we have seen, okay. Mostly in chapter number 2 I tried to cover finish Python syllabus, okay. In this Unit number 4 will understand how to write user-defined functions in the Python that we'll see, okay, definitely. Then how functions communicate with their environment or how functions are helping us to execute, how program will be executed. Then returning certain values from the function, this part already we have seen in C, C++. Only we'll understand in Python how to use functions. Scope in Python means what? Tuple dictionaries already I have covered here in chapter number 2, okay, in detail we have seen. Then only two chapters are remained where we'll understand module, packaging, string, okay, string almost I covered, okay, string part. List methods also I have covered, okay, exceptions, packages and modules we'll understand from this chapter number 5. Then if you will observe chapter number 6 where object-oriented programming approach is conveyed over here. So class, methods, objects, how to do an exception handling that we'll see in chapter number 6. In this way what will happen? I will try to cover, you know, within 10 more sessions are required. Maximum, I'm talking about maximum 10 more sessions. Or with the help of these 10 more sessions, I will try to cover entire syllabus. Okay, we'll see one by one and what kind of programs you will be writing as ICA part, that we'll see if time permits. Okay, so in this way, I will try to cover and see here. Basic important part is nothing but section 1. So whatever we understood, learned in section 1, that now directly will be applying in section number 2. So function, how to write function, what is my module, packages. So that we'll understand one by one. And then last approach, that is object-oriented programming, that also we'll see. So in this way what happens, I will try to cover a syllabus of this subject which is newly introduced in third year mechanical students, advanced programming concepts, and basically we are understanding Python, basics of Python. So that's it for the day. Thank you very much for attending this session.